Critical limb ischemia is the most advanced stage of peripheral arterial disease. The patients are at imminent threat of limb loss and a major or minor amputation if we don't revascularize. That means this is the aggressive side of the spectrum of the disease and not on the benign side like intermittent claudication.
Endovascular therapy plays a key role in the treatment of this condition because we have different options to perform the treatment, and understanding completely the endovascular strategies is very important in order to deliver the best care for affected patients.
The current evidence for the treatment of CLA nowadays is rather clear. We have different trial data available, and I especially want to highlight data from the Yukon trial. This is a drug-eluting stent trial using stents originally designed for coronary artery disease, which have been used in the below-the-knee area, and these stents have been compared to bare metal stents, and the outcome after 33 months is outstanding in terms of the results for the drug-eluting stent group in that manner that the amputation rate is dramatically reduced in this patient group to 5%.
Taking into consideration whether it is a diabetic foot ulcer or whether it is a proper gangrene or just rest pain, they may vary from a surgical bypass to an angioplasty depending also on their underlying patient comorbidities. Patients most often get treated with a percutaneous angioplasty because this is less invasive, it is considered to be safer, and in the long term has the same outcomes in terms of limb salvage and freedom from amputation.
The diabetic foot patient is different from all the other vascular patients because we need to take care of all his comorbidities. So we have very calcified vessels, we have wound, we have to take care of all the different aspects of these pathologies and create a foot team to give the best care to the affected patient.
Multidisciplinary teams is a key element of the treatment of critical limb ischemia, CLI in particular, diabetic foot ulcers even more so. They include a number of other disciplines, diabetologists, orthopedics, plastic surgeons, vascular surgeons, and above all, interventional radiologists. It is actually one of the easiest groups to get involved because the multidisciplinary nature of the team allows for quite productive and scientifically based discussions to take place, and that of course will allow the patient to enjoy the most meaningful and most successful treatment.
I think we have, even nowadays, to sharpen the awareness of interventional radiologists and the other surrounding disciplines on the fact what interventional radiology can offer. And we can offer, due to our exciting material we have nowadays available, a so-called straight line to the foot in order to keep the patient's foot in his shoe. I think for this very severely diseased patient group, we always have to look what can we improve, how can we improve our treatment algorithms, and drug-eluting balloon technology and also drug-eluting stent technology might be a further improvement for this severely diseased patient group.